Once Shri Lal Bahadur Shastri ji went to a textile mill and he was accompanied by owner of mill. After going around mill, Shastri ji went to see warehouse of that mill. There he saw some saris on display. Seeing those, Shastri ji requested owner of mill to show him some saris. Owner was happy with his request and asked his salesman to bring best saris to him. Owner showed him various kinds of saris and each one of them were unique and of high quality. Shastri ji liked one of those saris and asked owner about its price. Mill owner told him that cost of that sari was Rs. 800. After knowing sari cost, Shastri ji said, "This is too expensive. Can you please show me saris which are less expensive?" Owner asked his salesman to bring little less expensive saris to him. So the mill owner started showing him other saris, quoting prices like Rs. 500, Rs. 400 and so on. Shastri ji said, "These are still too expensive. Are there cheaper saris which a poor person like me can afford?" Owner was surprised by his response and said, "But you are Prime Minister of India. How can you be called poor? Moreover, you don't have to pay for any sari you take because this would be a gift for you." "No, my dear friend, I can't accept such expensive gifts," replied Shastri ji. Owner still insisted that it was his privilege that Prime Minister of India visited him and in return he want to offer sari as gift. To this, Shastri ji replied, "Yes, I may be the Prime Minister, but that does not mean that I should accept all those things that I cannot afford and give them to my wife. Although I am a Prime Minister, I am of limited means. Please show me some cheaper saris. I will buy those that I can afford." Finally, Shastri ji purchased a cheaper sari which he could afford for his wife. My dear brothers and sisters, Lal Bahadur Shastri ji was so honest and noble that temptations could not sway him at all. Hope you learn something from this inspirational story of Lal Bahadur Shastri ji. Subscribe this channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.